Papa Beep-a-doo-boo. Pretty baby.
Thank you.
Pretty baby. Buddy baby, buddy baby. Buddy baby, buddy.
An ancient door blocked our path forwards. With a low rumbling, the stone plinths shook, and then slowly parted. Peering into the small opening, a sense of claustrophobia took me back. After the incident, we were confined to the house. Mum and Dad were too worried for us to leave. As the hours dragged by, it felt like the walls were closing in around us. We stared longingly out the window, and I asked Oscar how he vanished. He said, if I promised not to tell, he'd show me. Our eyes adjusted to the darkness. Was this what she'd been searching for all these years? I offered to stay and help gather artifacts, but she insisted I carry on without her.
Thank you. Now you are. Thank you. Thank you.
I stepped over the broken glass towards the window. Those kids might be trouble, but they knew how to find a quick exit. Clambering through the makeshift opening, I said my farewells. And began my climb down to the ocean below. Looking back at their faces, I could picture Oscar amongst them, as if nothing had happened. Growing up, though, it was just the two of us, so we had to make do with each other. He'd show me how to create these doorways. And together, we'd sneak away on adventures to far-off places. Mom and Dad never even knew we left our room. I'd gotten down to safe ground, I spotted a sailboat tied up nearby. With the city on the horizon, I sailed off across the ocean. Did you hear that? I could have sworn I heard someone calling for help.
Tim went in. Went in by my gender, went to went it. When we were watching. Fishing dimp and wanted you went into it. I send Wim Van Action Wim Wim. And Tinch Wim Wim Tinch Wim. Try any more, Wim. CC Wim Wim. May CC Wim Wim. Sweet you, Bim Bim. Wimba Watson. Swy and Wimpa. I send Wimba an action, Wim Wim. Tin Bim Tim Wim Tim.
Thank you. Thank you.
I send Wim by an action, Wim. See, Wim. Where the pen?
Stepping foot into the fishing village, the seafarer's wife came running. They hadn't seen each other in so long, but she'd never given up hope. They invited me in, and we shared stories over dinner. She told of her worry. That first night her husband didn't come home. And I spoke of Oscar, and the day he too disappeared. We'd taken one of our many trips far away, but Oscar wanted to go even further this time. Crossing the river, he lost his footing and slipped. Before I knew what happened, he was gone. And that was the last time I saw my brother. I like to think he's waiting for me. On the other side, you know? After talking long into the night, the tide lowered, and a path opened up across the sea to the city. I said my farewells and made the short walk across to the harbor. According to this map, the university is just ahead. We finally made it.